wants to take with you. But I realize, beloved, that forgiveness has to begin in you, not in the other person. Forgiveness has to start in you, in me, not in the person, not in the other person. Genesis 45, verse 7 and 8. What does he say? He said, God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth and to save your lives by a great deliverance. So now it was not you that sent me hither, but God, and he hath made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house and a ruler throughout all the land of Egypt. You were not responsible for it. It was God. God did it. All things do work together for good to those who love God. That's the scripture that, beloved, we've got to get to you. But that's another sermon. You have to forgive yourself. Use the eye salve of love and understanding. Use the eye salve of mercy. Your eyes will begin to see a lot clearer. You will see as God sees. The Bible tells us if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John 1 and 9. When we forgive ourselves, note the middle of it, when we forgive ourselves, we will see clearer to forgive others when wrong is done. Forgiveness from the heart brings peace into your spirit. Do away with the blame game. It started in the garden. Do away with the blame game. Hold up to the unforgiveness. Ask God to forgive you. Repent of it at all times. When something has been done, beloved, and you have to forgive somebody, own up to it. Go ahead, forgive that person. Say you're sorry. Don't even expect that person to say, forgive me. You tell that person, forgive. Forgive me. Forgiveness from the heart brings joy to your spirit. Joy is lasting. Happiness is occasional. Forgiveness from the heart brings a human satisfaction that is incomparable.